Hey everyone, welcome back to another Counterside video. So this video will be short. I'll keep this sweet. We have a new update or probably another summoning banner tomorrow that is going to drop August 5 at 6 in the morning. GMT plus 7. The company will keep open for business during the cleaning so you can log in and play the game as usual. So let's take a look at what's going to drop tomorrow and see if we have something juicy. So we have updates, new content, recruit Ainz and Zwei, recruitment probability up, which is actually good for a lot of free-to-play players who weren't able to get this from the counter pass a couple of months ago. Or a month ago, I actually forgot. Number two, recruit Hayami Sanai, recruitment probability up, which is actually good as well. But more or less, majority will be going for Ainz and Zwei. Okay, buff dispatch mission, great success chance at 20% all day from August 5 to 8. And mail gifts, log in from August 6 to 11 to get special gifts from Ainz and Zwei. So please refer to the event for more details. So let's get to... Okay, so let's check them out. We're the twins, so let's go to management. I actually got them during the counter pass and pretty much very impressed of what they have been bringing me in terms of matches, PvP wise especially. So let's take a look at them now. So they are SSR counters, Ainz and Zwei. So I have them at 106 because of the copies for the counter pass. They're a striker, ground type, ground attack, and the most amazing thing about Ainz and Zwei is actually the 2 deployment cost. So let's take a look at their in terms of the stat modifications. They're good at 40 for me. Attack could be better at 2947, but again, their survivability is very good and they have high evasion. So if you look at their skills, basic skill, so valid hits is 2. Ainz and Zwei swings their sword, inflicting AoE damage. Level 2 to 5, basic attack damage is increased to a total of 20. Their passive skill is Together We're Strong. Ainz enters the battle with Zwei, her identical twin, who has the same stats and gears as her. Ainz and Zwei increases damage resistance by 30%. That is why they are very tough to kill, even if they're strikers, when they're together on the battlefield, of course. Level 2, 3, 4, HP total plus is going to be 20%, and on level 5, additional skill haste plus 30% for Ainz and attack plus 30% for Zwei. Again, for 2 deployment cost, they pack a lot of punch. That is why I like them very much, and that is why they're being banned all the time. Special skill, Doppelklingen. So 18 seconds valid hits is 2. AoE, Ainz and Zwei shoot spirit swords at enemies in front, inflicting AoE damage. When Ainz casts the skill, Zwei responds by casting the same skill. So copies of the skill. Okay, level 2, 3, and 4 damage is a total plus of 25%. Level 5 is inflicts true damage if cast by Zwei and Ainz is on the battlefield. True damage, from my understanding, is actually ignoring defense. Okay, so ultimate skill would be Stark Schwestern. Okay, 46 seconds, valid hits is 3. Ainz summons all her siblings, inflicting AoE damage and on and around the target, invincible during skill. Damage increased by 25%, 2, 3, 4 levels. Then at level 5, instant cooldown minus 20% after skill if Zwei is on the battlefield. Again, the twins work very well when they're together. They are tanky in a way. They're tanky and they bring a lot of utility, and they have an AoE special skill, which I actually like. So again, they can take care of the backline. When they shoot their special skill, it usually reaches the backline. So that is why I like the both of them. They take care of your rangers at the back, probably some of your supporters. That is why they are very good at 2 skill deployment. Okay, so what I have with them is actually evasion, additional evasion for the twins and additional HP as well. I could have put this at 3,000. I think need to do some enhancements in their kit. So they're at +5 right now, which I'm leaving them at. But again, the twins are very, very good in terms of what they bring into the game. The next banner up will be for Hayami Sanai, where is she? She's actually a sniper. So Hayami is again a sniper, counter SSR as well, ground type, ground attack. So for Hayami, I'll go reverse this time. So for her gear, I put her at critical damage. She actually has a hit, very high hit, and decent crit. That is why I put critical damage on her. And again, she has very high attack, and she's really a sniper, so she's squishy. But again, in rush situations, she is one of the best snipers that you can bring, because she actually, her big gun is actually like a very big lightsaber, so it projects a light towards the back, and it's very long. So let's take a look at her skills. So Hayami Sanai, basic attack, basic skill, validity 2 hits, fires a special heavy firearm inflicting AoE damage on and around the foremost target. Again, basic attack damage is a total of +20 from level 2 to level 5. Passive skill, interceptive tactics, commands her forces to respond to enemies in front. She and surrounding units inflict 20% more damage on siege units. That is why she was actually very, very popular in terms of siege units. And levels 2, 3, 4 passive buff effect is a total of 20%. And on level 5, also melee damage taken is -30%. Okay, special skill Inazuma Ray. So this is actually one of the skills that I like. 22-second cooldown, valid hits is 3, so AoE. Fires a lightning-like laser beam. This is what I meant earlier. Inflicting AoE damage, this laser beam knocks backward enemies in front with more force for those closer to the blast. Okay, damage level 2, 3, 4. Maximum of +25% and a cooldown decrease of 4 seconds, which brings it down to 18 seconds cooldown. Then the last is her ultimate skill, so Raikou Blaster, 50-second cooldown, valid hits is 4, which is actually very good as well. Causes a powerful explosion that resembles a decent descent of the Thunder God. Inflicting AoE damage decreases many attack speed by 30% for 6 seconds. Okay, damage, additional damage would be 25%, 2, 3, 4 levels, and on level 5 it's a -10 seconds cooldown, which brings the cooldown of ultimate skill to 40 seconds. So again, she is probably one of the better rush snipers, or the best ones out there, because again, she pushes enemies back to the ship. And again, I've seen team comps that bring her in terms of early damage team comps, and she is actually very good. So that is it, guys. So there you have it, Hayami Sanai and Ainsen's Way for your banners tomorrow. No other additions for this update. So who you gonna pick? Most of you guys are going to get Ainsen's Way, I'm sure. Then this is going to be a very good banner. I'm not sure if I'm going to pull for Ainsen's Way. Probably have some little pulls here and there, because I already have, they already are at plus, are at 106, level 106. But if I want copies of them, I think this is a good banner to pull, especially that it's a rate up. So again, guys, thank you very much for staying this long in this video. Please consider subscribing. Also, please click the bell icon, and also please put a like to this video if you like this type of content. Guys, take care, stay safe. This is the Warden, and I'm out of here.